Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss about the climate of India. Before going to that, we should know the difference between the weather and climate. So what is weather? Weather, it is a state of atmospheric conditions of elements like sunshine, temperature, humidity, precipitation, atmospheric pressure, clouds, etc. over an area in a particular period. Climate refers to weather condition over a large area for a long period, 30 years or more than 30 years is called climate. Actually, this is not fluctuated often like the weather. Of course, sometimes we get more rainfall in 1 year and sometimes we get lower rainfall in other year. But there is no particular pattern is changed in the climate. The particular pattern is not changed. The graphs which will show the elements of weather or climate are called climographs. It is nothing but climographs shows the monthly values of maximum temperature, minimum temperature, rainfall and other elements. What are the factors influencing the weather and climate? Of course, in India, various types of physical features, plains, mountains, coastal region, and islands, these types of various factors are there. Now, we are going to know about the what are the factors influencing the weather and climate. The first one is the latitude. Second, land water relationship. Third, relief or altitude. Fourth, upper air circulation. Now we discuss about the latitude. You know, the Tropic of Cancer is passing through the almost center of the India. It is divided India into two parts, northern part, southern part. Already we know, we have learnt in 9th class, the upper part on the Tropic of Cancer lies in the temperate zone. The lower part on the Tropic of Cancer lies in the tropical zone. So automatically we know the difference between the tropical zone and the temperate zone. So automatically this causes to the variation of climatic conditions in India. Then, and also we know that the temperature at higher latitudes is low, the temperature at lower latitude is high because of the insolation, incoming solar radiation. Now the equatorial zone or tropical zone receives more energy from the sun. Automatically it leads to the more temperature. The temperate zone, it receives less temperature. The rising of sunlight and reflection of sunlight depends upon the nature of the land. Generally, we know the thick forest are the good absorbers of the sunlight, and the snow covered areas in Himalayan region are the good reflectors. So according to the reflection and absorption leads to the retainment of temperature on the earth surface. So automatically the temperature in the northern areas of the India varied from the southern area of India. The northern area of India has low temperature. The southern area of India has high temperature. And in southern area, there are two types of areas are there. Coastal areas and some of the lands far from the coastal area. They are called continental lands. The continental lands must not affect by the coastal atmosphere. Generally, you see the Chennai, it is a coastal city. When we compare to the continental land to Chennai, the temperature and weather conditions are varied. And when we compare to Delhi and Chennai, the temperature and other conditions are varied. Generally, we know the water absorbs and loses temperature slowly than land. Automatically, the oceans also absorbs and loses the temperature slowly than land. So, this effect is more on Indian climate because our Indian peninsula is surrounded by water, surrounded by large amount of water. So, you know the connection between the high pressure and low pressure. When the land receives more temperature, automatically the low pressure is created there. In the same way, when as in the same time on the ocean, temperature is low when we compare to the temperature of land. So automatically the high pressure, atmospheric pressure is on ocean, the low atmospheric pressure on land. The main principle is that winds blow from high pressure to low pressure. Automatically the breezes starts from the ocean to land. Okay, in the night suddenly all the temperature is reflected and land loses temperature. While the land lost the temperature, high pressure is created on the land, low pressure is created on ocean. Then the breeze starts the journey from the land to ocean. So these types of land and sea breezes are occurred. Due to that, the areas covered in this type of climate like Chennai or other are not affected more in summer. So temperature and other variations are not much. This type of climate is called equable climate. Next, relief or altitude. Temperature decreases as latitude increases. And when the height is increased, temperature is decreased. So automatically on the top of the hills and mountains, temperature is not much. You know the summer hill stations, Shimla, Darjeeling, Nainital, like that. And in South India, Ooty, Kodaikanal. The people goes to hill stations in the summer because they get comfortable temperature. So this is the main factor. Height, temperature depends upon the height, altitude. Children, we know the trade winds. We studied in the 9th class. Subtropical high pressure belt creates trade winds. These trade winds blows towards the equatorial low pressure belt and high pressure belts to low pressure belts by reflected to westward. Our India lies in the north, dry northeast trade wind zone. So automatically the temperature in the northern areas of the India Very from the southern area of India.